Hello, everyone. This is Pastor Sean from Christians Unite, and this is another edition of Reading Through the Bible. On today's episode of Reading Through the Bible, we're going to be looking at James chapter 1. From James, a servant of God and the Lord Jesus Christ, greetings to all God's people scattered over the whole world. Faith and wisdom. My brothers, consider yourself fortunate when all kinds of trials come your way. For you know when your faith succeeds in facing such trials, the result is the ability to endure. But be sure your endurance carries you all the way without failing, so that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. But if any of you lacks wisdom, he should pray to God, who will give it to you for him. For God gives generously and graciously to all. But you must believe when you pray and not doubt at all. For whoever doubts is like a wave in the sea that is driven and blown out by the wind. And such person must not think that he will receive anything from the Lord. For he is unsure and undeceived, or undecided in every step he takes. So this is talking about in daily life. And throughout our lives, we're going to have trials and tribulations. Now, sometimes these are on purpose to give us endurance to learn how to handle certain situations. So in any situation, we should also be praying for guidance and wisdom or any knowledge or anything that we may need. But in that prayer, we must not doubt the power of God that he will do what we ask if it is his will. If we doubt, it's not going to happen because we don't have the faith in God that we need. Poverty and riches. Verse number 9. The poor brother must be proud when God lifts him up, and the rich brother when God brings him down. For the rich will pass away like the bloom of a wild plant. The sun rises when its blazing heat and burns the plants. Its bloom falls off and its beauty is destroyed. In the same way, the rich man will be destroyed while busy conducting his affairs. So in this section of scriptures, all earthly possessions, anything that you gain through wealth, when we die and go to heaven, that stuff stays here. You can't bring your wealth to heaven. So we shouldn't be going after material things while we're on this earth. We should be focused on the kingdom of God and doing his will to store up treasures in heaven. Testing and tempting. Verse 12. Happy is the man who remains faithful under trials, for when he succeeds in passing the test, he will be given life, the prize which God has promised to those who love him. If a man is tempted by such testing, he must not say the temptation comes from God, for God cannot be tempted by evil, and he himself tempts no one. But a person is tempted when he is drawn away and trapped by his own evil desire. Then his evil desire conceives and gives birth to sin. And sin, when is full grown, gives birth to death. Do not be deceived, my dear brothers. Every good gift and every perfect present comes from heaven. It comes down from God, the creator of the heavenly lights. He does not change, nor does he cause darkness by turning. By his own will, he brought us into being through the word of truth, that we should occupy first place among all his creatures. So this is saying that everything that God does, it is good. So anything that we receive is a gift from God. Now, when we're tempted, that is our sin nature, us giving into that. And that causes us to be drifted away from God. That's by our own doing. Sometimes we can also be tempted by Satan to do evil things, but it's never God. So we can't blame God for tempting us, because it's not possible for him to do so. But we must know that our own evil desires cause us to sin. And we need to restrict those temptations and follow God's path. Hearing and doing. Verse 19. Remember this, my dear brothers. Everyone must be quick to listen, but slow to speak, and slow to become angry. For man's anger does not help to achieve God's righteous purpose. Rid yourself, then, of every filthy habit and wicked conduct. Submit to God and accept the word that he plants in your hearts, which is able to save you. Do not fool yourselves by just listening to his word. Instead, put it into practice. For whoever listens to the word but does not put it into practice is like a man that looks in the mirror and sees himself as he is. He takes a look at himself and then goes away, and at once forgets what he looks like. But the man who looks closely in the perfect law that sets men free, who keeps on paying attention to it, and does not simply listen and then forgets it, but puts it into practice, that man will be blessed by God in what he does. Does anyone think he is a religious man? If he does not control his tongue, his religion is worthless, and he deceives himself. This is what God the Father considers to be pure and genuine religion: to take care of orphans and widows in their suffering, and to keep oneself from being corrupted by the world. So, to me, what I hear from this section of scripture is that you can go to church, you can listen to my videos, other people's videos all day long. But if you're just listening to it and not applying what's being spoken and not actually following the word of God, then you're really not doing anything at all. So anything we listen to, whether it be reading directly from the word of God or another format from someone that is speaking out of the Bible so that we may know what God says, we should be following and doing and not just listening and moving on with our lives. Thank you for listening to this edition of Reading Through the Bible. We will be back tomorrow for topics.